WebInspect 20.1 delivers Macro Engine 5.0 for advanced login and workflow macro recording capabilities of all your legacy apps, as well as those applications built in modern JavaScript frameworks. Taking a look at WebInspect 20.1, you'll notice that Macro Engine 5.0 is integrated everywhere, from the freestanding login macro recorders to the workflow macro recorder, as well as in guided scan, as well as in basic scan. Macro Engine 5.0 is integrated everywhere across the product. In today's example, we'll use the basic scan wizard to record a login macro. For our sample application, we'll use WebGoat 8. WebGoat 8 is an intentionally vulnerable, single-page application built in JavaScript frameworks. As I configure the scan, take note that the rendering engine is set at Macro Engine 5.0. I'll next through, enable site authentication, and then click the record button to begin recording my login macro. As the macro engine opens, you'll notice that the status bar gives us an indication of what's going on with the macro recorder at this point in time. Also notice that the control bar provides advanced options like editing logout conditions, creating and editing parameters, options for configuring general settings, granularity controls, as well as a host of other extensibility options via the toolbox on the left-hand side. To get started recording our login macro, we'll click the red record button in the top control bar. We'll then enter our username and our password, and we'll click the sign in button. You'll notice the recorder is recording down in the bottom left-hand status bar, and now we've logged into our application. We'll now click the stop button to indicate that we've finished logging into the application, and the play button to play back our login macro. As the macro plays back, you'll see the status and the status bar updating. Once the macro is completed logging in, you'll be prompted for positive verification of login. This is an element that indicates that you are in fact logged in. Once you've identified that element, the login macro recorder will detect a logout condition for you. At this point, your login macro is complete. For more advanced use cases and extensibility options, keep in mind that we do provide the toolbox. The toolbox provides you with a lot of options to add extensibility and greater flexibility to your login macros. You can insert things like waits, so waiting for a specific object before another step in the login macro executes. You can enter JavaScript options. All sorts of sort of more powerful use cases can be achieved with the toolbox. And we'll do a deeper dive on that in a later video. Finally, keep in mind that you can drill into individual steps, set those steps as optional, change parameters, change timeouts, all sorts of different options that you may or may not be aware are actually possible using the True Client login macro recorder. Here we're just showing where you can set some of those steps as optional. Okay, so with the macro complete, we'll save this script and we'll next through to start and run our scan. In the site tree of this example, you'll see the login page and you'll notice the posts where we're logging in with a username and password. We can also switch over to the sequence view. The sequence view will give us kind of a good feel for where we're doing a post again to log into this application using our credentials. And finally, keep an eye on the dashboard. There's lots of good information over here around scan statistics, but in particular around login macros. So you'll see the number of logouts, so the number of times that we lost state and the login macro had to refire. So this, you can kind of get a sense for potential problems with your login macro. Maybe you need to fine tune the logout condition to make it a little more prescriptive, those types of things. So make sure those numbers stay low, but also you want to see them firing some so that you can ensure that you're getting good logged in coverage of the application. So I hope this video was helpful. Keep an eye out on Fortify Unplugged for more videos around some of the more advanced use cases for the macro recorder, as well as some videos around our Postman integration and other awesome features coming in WebInspect 20.1. Thanks.